Hello, everyone. I am Aquatavius, and welcome to another episode of Survival Island. This is the adventure where we began with no island. We were completely stranded out here in the middle of the ocean without food to eat, a bed to sleep in, and while clearly there's no trees, that means no wood to even make a crafting table so that we can interact with the world. But as we can see here, I am standing on some wood. So how did we do it? Well, the whole reason why we were stranded out here was because we were shipwrecked. So we went out and salvaged our ship. But that only got us so much wood. As we could see, we literally only have 10 birch planks and 3 sticks left. That is literally it. So the rest of our survival depends on these 10 birch planks and 3 sticks. Now for the food situation, we were able to get kelp. And for the sleeping, we were able to make a spider farm to make ourselves some nice silky sheets. Now to anyone here in the last episode, hello, we will remember that Mr. Dr. Professor Gerald III gives us the ability to get sticks, which are dropped by witches, which spawn on rare occasions. So this acts as a stick farm, which is great because that is half of what is required to make tools. And to be on the safe side, we're going to build something that's going to act as a failsafe. Let me explain. So let's say we use or lose all of our diamonds and iron. Let's say we're too dumb and we die or something. Well, we should be fine because we could just take some sticks here, combine it with some cobblestone, make a stone pickaxe, and try to get us back up to where we left off. But I'm also the person to be extremely careless, which means I might end up actually placing all of our cobblestone. And then if we die, that would mean we literally have no way to make a tool. We would just have the sticks. Yeah, and that's it. So what we're going to do is make a spot here to make a little contraption so that if all of those things go wrong, we are guaranteed to be able to recoup and continue conquering the ocean. So let's build it. The only thing we need are these 5 items here and plus some blocks, and our choice is going to be polished andesite. So we're going to place one here, put the stair on top, build up 3 high all around, place our water on the stairs, cover it up, place another right here. And now we're going to put lava on top, place our door, and lastly, put the obsidian in the back. We're going to get a hopper, place it here so that we don't lose any, and mine 3 cobblestone. And there we go. So now we're going to take these 3, get our hopper back, put a dropper in its place, and put the 3 cobblestone there. And we're never going to touch this again. We're going to grab one of our remaining signs, put it on the door, and write failsafe, do not enter. And let's just hope that I can follow directions. So this means no matter what happens out here, we will be able to make a pickaxe and recover back from nothing. I can't get over how funny this looks. It's just like a porta potty just chilling in the middle of the ocean. I love it. It is now morning of day 168. And the first project that we're going to tackle is making more farms for our potatoes, which we got from a zombie. But to do this, we need to go down into the mines and collect all of the dirt that we exposed during our mining expeditions, so that we can create enough farm space. Because I don't know about you guys, but I really want to get to planting. So let's go. So we're going to explore our entire mine here that goes around us in 360 degrees. And wish us luck that we don't get lost. Yo, we found diamonds. Let's go. See, this is why you punch dirt. And now we're going to pull out our Fortune 3 pickaxe. So we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 diamonds. 13. Oh, that's so amazing. So the aqua affinity that we got in the last episode is definitely coming in handy because a lot of these places get flooded by all the places where we put the sea pickles. And some of these areas are just massive. Hey, we found some more lapis. Yeah, every time I played, I've always had a shortage of lapis. So this is definitely a good find. All right, so we went around all the dirt patches and collected them. Gonna also grab the rest of our torches from the giant square that we made in the last episode. And we've almost filled up 2 entire droppers, which adds up to 1,000 dirt. Who says you need to be dirty to take a shower? Why not take a shower of dirt? Okay, was that kind of cringe? That was kind of cringe. No way. Thank God we didn't cook all of these because this is the last of our potatoes. We only have 5 to start from now because we just made them all into baked potatoes. Oh my goodness, how tragic that would have been. I gotta say, I love having such a unique world like this. We're just here in the ocean, and like, what is this? What is that? I'm loving this. If you're loving it, be sure to hit the like button. It helps me out a ton. And thank you. Is that just a white fish? It is just a white fish. Ooh, I like it. Haha, Gerald. Finally a use for our silk touch pickaxe. And there you go. He's beautiful, I love him.
All these guys are just chilling.
Okay, so now we are ready to get to planting. We have expanded the island quite a bit. Can I make this? Woo! And it is so nice. I feel so free. Like, we're not claustrophobic out here anymore. We got potatoes growing here. We got some more over on here, and we'll fill this up eventually. What I'm hoping is that we'll actually get a carrot drop from a zombie at some point, and so we can grow carrots here.
And we also got our pumpkins.
Now, before we get ahead to making a carved pumpkin and crafting an iron golem, we have been visited by the wandering trader. Oh, they want to be with their friends. They want in. You guys want in? All right, we'll let these guys join the crew. Now, let's see what you got, sir. Okay, we have ink, naughty shell, rooted dirt. I'm not happy with those trades. You know what that means. Give me your face. Don't at me, bro. Don't at me. Oh, he's following us. Oh, he's on the hunt. Why is this so frightening? Go away. He's just going to pop around the corner somewhere. Oh, there he is. We're actually playing hide and seek with an alpaca. Where is he? Oh, he's up there. Oh, dude. It is on. It is on. Wait. We got an advancement? Yo, let's go. Ah! Dude, you're a lame shot. You can't even hit me from there. All right, well, we might as well try to tame these two. And there's one and two. How are we going to get this guy out of here? Come on. Welcome to your new home. All right, so now that we got all that cleared up, it is time to make my first ever carved pumpkin. Ooh, wait. Oh, that is awesome. But a little too spooky. I'm going to take it off. That is so cool. I love that's a feature. And now we're going to make four iron blocks. And you all know what's coming. But before we do that, we're going to modify one of our farms here so that it can work for us in the meantime while we work on the next project. And that is the spider farm over here. We're going to try to get a rail system here that uses our last hopper. So, of course, we'll make this into a hopper minecart and set it free on some rails. So this way we can at least get some string instead of needing to manually come here every single time just to collect a little tiny bit here and there. It can now do the work for us. And I honestly gotta say, it's about time. This spider farm is like literally the first thing we made, and we haven't even automated it at all yet. So let's fix that. So while we're smelting the gold, we do hear a witch, which may be another opportunity for another stick. Uh-oh, there's a problem. There's a problem here. It was literally this one spot right here. All right, now that we got that solved for now, we did not get any sticks from the witch. Okay, that's unfortunate. Now we can take our gold, line it up like this, put a stick here, redstone, and now we just got six more powered rails. Gonna make two redstone blocks, and now we need to figure out a good pattern for this. And I believe we got one. So we're gonna put a block here, put a redstone block on each side, take our powered rails, and there we go. That should do it. Now we'll take a minecart, combine the two, and our first hopper minecart. Ooh. And okay, it gets stuck. Oh, I didn't realize that if you mine a hopper minecart with a pickaxe, you can actually get your hopper back. You just have to recraft it, but that's fine. Nothing gets destroyed. Sweet. So this is like a hopper on a temporary mission, and then if we need it back, we can always use it for something else. Oh, that is so cool. Okay, hoping this works. Oh, there we go. Hey, look at that. Now we're going to test it. Hey. And it took it. Let's go. So now we finally automated our string farm. And it's honestly not too loud. Being just this far away from it, I don't hear a thing. I am loving progress so far. And speaking of progress, that's our cue to hop into the mines and begin the slime farm. Now, our two slime chunks are over here, and I'll make this easier for you guys to see. So the thing is, slimes are attracted to iron golems. So we're going to make spawning platforms along the edges, put an iron golem here in the middle, so it attracts the slimes towards a hole around here, and we'll bring them to a drowning chamber. Now, it would be great if we had magma blocks, because then that is a very efficient and easy way to kill them. However, we have to do the long and tedious drowning method, and I hope we get it right. So we're going to mark the corners, turn off the overlay, and time for me to spend like 3 hours on this, and that is why I'm going to boot up a live stream for us. Be sure to follow my Twitch channel so that when we do go live, you can get notified and participate as like a sneak peek to the episode. We get the chat, answer questions, comments, and all that goody stuff while we're spending like a bunch of time together just having fun conquering this world. So the link to that will be in the description. Help! 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 I don't like this! I don't like this! Ah! Okay. Those noises just scared me. I just hear something creeping up on us. I'm just like, ah! Oh, man. Wow, this looks pretty cool. I have never mined like this before, where I actually exposed all the ores. This looks sick. So now what we're gonna do is go around with a Fortune 3 and get a final tally of everything we get. Now, the interesting thing about this is we have updated to a newer version of Minecraft, which means iron can now be affected by Fortune 3. So we mined 3 and we got 6. I totally didn't use the wrong pickaxe for like half of this. But yeah, it's cleared out now and we did get some resources. I can't believe I made that mistake. Oh, don't get close. I'm psyching myself out. I just gotta leave. I'm not safe. I'm not a safe person. But yeah, we are looking for gold. We're gonna need it to help collect these slime balls. Yes, gold. Okay, we found some. And this time we're using our fortune pick. And now the time has come for us to use our last two sticks. And hopefully in a little bit, we'll get some more sticks from the witches. That dropped down from Gerald's insert censorship here. Yeah. We're gonna make more powered rails and regular rails. And also, the time has come for us to decide what we're gonna do with our wood. Cause if it's just sitting here, it's not doing anything for us. So we're actually gonna put this to work in the slime farm. So we're gonna make it into a chest. And then from a chest, into a hopper. And then from a hopper, into a hopper minecart. Now we have 2 pieces of birch planks left. No sticks, and that's it. Oh my gosh, we actually did it. And here we are in the killing chamber. We're going to put 2 powered rails here, a regular rail in the middle. Put a block of redstone on each side so that the power rails get powered. And put the hopper minecart on top. This is the collection system that will work for the killing chamber that we're going to make right now. So normally to do this, we need 9 signs. But as you know, we can't make 9 signs with only 2 birch planks left. So we have to improvise. So we're going to put some stone pressure plates here. Take our 2 trap doors, put them on the wall here. Now we have to go up, and this is the only available sign that we have, so we have to take it, put it in the middle, and put slabs on top where there is supposed to be signs here. And this now makes this area 2.5 blocks tall, which is exactly the size of the largest slimes. And they will just be able to fit in between all of this as we set up our drowning chamber now. And there we go. And now part 1 of the killing chamber is now complete. And this is part 2. I'm not even going to bother to explain this. You'll see it work later. Just know it took a lot of trial and error. This platform is now finished, but before the farm is completely functional, we have to make the iron golem chamber. So to do this, we're gonna take this circle up a little further, and there we go, there should be enough room. And now to make the platform that the iron golem is going to stand on. And I just used this for reference. And then we're gonna put slabs on the edges of 2 of the corners. So what this will do is he'll be too tall, And when he tries to walk off, this will keep him contained. So we're going to do that for the other side as well. And there we go. We now should be able to craft our iron golem. You know, assuming we don't mess this up or anything. I'm going to take down this corner, and we're going to try to enclose him in. And this way, I don't have to worry about being a dumb. And here we go. Oh, I'm so excited and I'm so nervous at the same time. Okay. Wait, what? Let's try this again. What do you mean? Oh, there we go. Okay, this goes here. No, that goes there. And then above here, I need to move him. There we go. Is he fully contained? I believe he's contained. Okay, that's great. That's actually fantastic. You are absolutely gorgeous, my good sir. Incredibly stunning.
Yeah.
And the last thing to do is rearrange our torches so that they are in a more efficient pattern. And now that we're all cleaned up, we're going to try to make this a little bit more efficient by allowing the line of sight to get to the slimes that are all the way back here. So we're going to mine out a little bit so that he can see them and that they could see him, you know, vice versa, all that good stuff. And there he go. There we go. The slimes can see him no matter where they are. Yeah, I'm just like Iron Golem chilling up there, dude. That's so cool. And we're going to make sure the slimes can't get out of the water tunnel. Now I can't get out. I don't know why I made that noise. Okay. This is cool, too. You could see up there. This is awesome. You could see what's happening. So, yes, it is now 100% complete. It is day 195. We're going to check back up on this once it hits day 200, if we remember, and see how many slime balls we have. You know, and I might have just realized a design flaw. Slimes could still spawn down here. Do we just flood the whole thing? I mean, that is a solution. We were going to turn this all into a massive dropper wall, and this would be our storage room. But if there's going to be slimes here, man, I'm going to get a little bit worried. I don't know. I did some soul searching, and I think the best thing to do is to just fortune 3 the ores that are on the ground and put slabs over the entire thing so we can remove these sea pickles. And there we go. This is now completely spawn-proofed. Just the minecart going back and forth. Nice. I like it. The slime farm is done. Oh? Ooh, there one goes. Hey, you fell into the pool? And if we wait a moment... And there we go! We have a successful slime farm. My first ever that I have built. And thanks for sharing this memory with me. It makes me happy, man. You know, if you were a like button, I'd slap you. Why does that sound insulting? Meaning I would press all of your like buttons. Okay, that, I just, moving on. Well, that is going to do it for today's episode. We have run out of video time, and man, we did make a crap ton of progress. I am super happy with it. Now, I did have some technical difficulties when editing because we had some corrupted footage that we had to salvage in a very unique way, which we did that on stream. Again, I'm advertising those streams. They're a lot of fun. Go check them out. But yeah, that is going to do it. Finally got this episode out. It took about 2 weeks. Man, it was a doozy to get through the technical difficulties. But thank you for your appreciation and support for the series so far. You guys really make all the difference. You have no idea how much it means to me having you guys as my community. It's like I'm actually building a community. Like, I have a community. Like, I remember in the first episode, I said, be sure to drop a comment, be in before I'm famous. And like, we're starting to build up a community. And I can't be happier with the people, you guys, who are that community. And I just wanted to say, I love you. Really. That's it. That's all I got. Bye. Ta-ta. Wow, okay. I had the genuine energy the first time, and then I'm all stupid.